So my novel, My Name in the Dark, is the story of a group of neighbors who live in Virginia and are forced to flee this small town because of violence, racialized violence, white supremacists coming to their town. And it echoes a real event that took place in Charlottesville, Virginia, where I live, this small town. And they end up taking refuge in Monticello, Thomas Jefferson's plantation home, which is about 10 minutes from my home. So the novel is, like most dystopian novels, it really is talking about a present. So I was really thinking about present events and imagining them just a little bit into the future, exaggerating them just a little bit. And hopefully as a cautionary tale of what I hoped would not happen in the future, to let people kind of preview and think about and look at that more closely. There's this tiny little utopia hidden in this dystopia. And so more than a criticism, it's kind of an examination of how we might respond to obscene events, to social events, to movements that we disagree with, without losing our own sense of humanity, of grace, of kindness, of care, and of community. So I kind of wanted to, I'm kind of an introvert, and I wanted to get my revenge against this kind of terrible movement. So I did it by writing like a novel of kind of what I think we should be doing and how I think we might respond. All the action of the novel takes place in the present, the near future, but the novel does talk about, echo, and think about the past. And the way it does this is through a young protagonist, college student, who's reading the text of Thomas Jefferson, who happens to be her great-great-great-great-great-grandfather. So she is a black descendant of Thomas Jefferson and an enslaved woman named Sally Hemings, with whom Jefferson really had children. She's this imagined descendant. So she's really thinking not about American history, but about family history, her own family's legacy. I really wanted to create this community of neighbors, some of whom know each other, some who don't, mostly black and brown people, but also white neighbors that they have, and the protagonist's boyfriend, who's also white, and having them be forced into this situation up at the Museum of Monticello, and for them to have to reckon with how they are or are not going to create a community. I was a public school teacher for 20 years. I taught elementary school children, so young children, art. And so I really have this model of communal spaces where, you know, all kinds of people have to come together and decide to work together towards a cause. So I really use that as a model for how my characters might do this at Monticello under much more harrowing circumstances. So I had been writing for many, many years while teaching. I've loved writing for a long time. And this was my first book to come out. It came out when I was 50 years old. And to my great delight and surprise, it was received really well. I had sent other manuscripts out, so I know that this doesn't always happen. But in this case, I was able to find editors and agents and people who were really excited about it. It was nominated for several national book prizes and won several regional book prizes, so I was really excited about that. Mm-hmm.